Good evening students, this is the 6th lecture video on classes and objects. So first of all we have to understand what is class and what is objects. Whenever we are having a structured program, we have methods and variables inside the class, and we can able to call the class inside the main function. How can we will call the class? We can able to create object for the class. With use of the object, we can able to call the method inside the class. Okay. Now, we going to see a sample program with use of class and objects. So let's see this program, class A. Inside class A, we are having a method named as void fun. So inside void fun, I am just making a print statement, system.out.println. Inside that I am just making a statement as inside class A and function fun, that will be printed as output. I am closing class A. I am creating class B. Inside class B we are having public static void main as a main function, and we are creating object for the class A. How to create object for the class A? Class name space object name is equal to new class name. So here the class name is A, so that we are giving capital A space object name as obj equal to new class name A again, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, semicolon. And we have to call the method. Method is fun inside the class A. So that we have to call the fun by giving obj.fun. When we are giving obj.fun, the fun will be called and it will execute the statement inside class A and function fun. And it will print that as an output. And the control will be come out of the program. Okay. So this is the first program with a basic class with a method, and we are creating a class with a main function and we are calling the class. So this is the second program. We are having parameter passing. So parameter passing, we are passing parameters to the function from the main function. While doing the function call, we are just passing the parameters. So the same thing, I am repeating the same program for example, and I am just doing a modification in the parameter passing. So here class A, we are having opening the class A, we are having function, we are having a single parameter, that is to be integer x as a parameter for the function fun. Inside the function we are just having system.out.println, and the parameter is plus x. So plus is a concatenation operator, x is the variable that we are printing. Closing the function, closing the class A. We are creating class B. Inside class B, we are having main function, public static void main. Opening public static void main, we are just creating object for class A. A space obj is equal to new A we are giving, so that the object is created. Then obj.fun. Obj.fun, we are calling the function by calling the function by passing parameter 5. So 5 is a parameter. So 5 will be passed as a parameter while doing function call. So it will call the function fun. So the 5 will be stored in x, and x will be printed as output. So it will print the output as the parameter is 5. Okay. So this is the second program for understanding parameter passing. So the third program we are doing with method overloading. So method overloading, what is method overloading? We are having same function name with different parameters that we discussed in C++ programming. The same thing we are repeating in Java programming also. So what we are doing here, we are having class A. Inside that we are having two functions, void fun. The both function names are same name, so that we are calling this as a method overloading. First function name void fun, we are passing a single parameter int x. Inside the fun, we are just printing the x value as output. So we are giving system.out.println, and we are printing the x value. So second function void fun, we are passing two parameters int y comma float z. So two parameters we are passing. So we are just printing y and z as output inside the second function. And we are closing the function, we are closing the class A. Inside the class B we are having the main function. Inside the main function what we are having, we are just creating the object for class A. A space obj is equal to new A. And we have to call both the functions, mean by we have to call both the functions with different parameters. Obj.fun of 5 we are giving, so it will call the first function. It having single parameter, that is an integer parameter. next again we are calling obj.fun 10, 5.6f. So 10 and 5.6f. So 10 is a integer variable and 5.6 is a floating point variable. So both we are passing and calling the second function. So in this program you can understand the method overloading by passing two different parameters. One is integer parameters, another one is integer and floating point parameter. So this is an example for method overloading. Next one is we are having this keyword. In this keyword, this refers the current object. This refers the current object. Let's see, class A, we are having int roll number. So here in this program we are creating a constructor. Okay, so here you have to do the modification. Instead of student, you have to put A. A is a constructor, A of int roll number. So A of int roll number you have to give. So we are creating constructor and we are having a variable inside the constructor. Opening that, this dot roll number is equal to roll number. So this dot roll number refers the variable created inside the class A, and that equal to roll number we are giving, that is a parameter what we are passing to the constructor. The only modification in this program is instead of student you have to put A. Okay, that's a mistake I did. Coming down, we are having a display function, void display. Opening the display function, we are just displaying the roll number. So whatever the roll number we assigned in the previous constructor, that we are printing as output. So we are having constructor inside the class and we are having a display method inside the class. So we are creating class B. Inside class B we are having main function and we are creating object for the class A. Okay, so A space s1 is equal to new A 111 you have to give. So A space s1 is equal to new A 111 you have to give. Then s1 dot display you have to give. So it will call the method. So A space s1 is equal to new A of 111, that will call the constructor, and whatever 111 you are giving, that will be passed as a parameter to the constructor A, and it will stored in the this dot roll number. Next we are calling the display method s1 dot display. So display method will be called. There we are just printing the roll number as output. Okay, so what the modification you have to do, wherever you are finding student, there you have to replace with A. So A is a constructor for the class A. Same way, inside class B we are creating object for class A. So A space s1 is equal to new A of 111. Okay, that the modification you have to do in this program. So this refers the current object. So this dot roll number mean by the roll number what we are created inside the class E. Okay, I hope you understand this program. We can move for the exercise. So in this video we have discussed classes and passing parameters to the classes, method overloading and this keyword. Okay, so first exercise, write a program to create three different classes named add, sub and mul. Inside every class you have to create methods. So inside add class you have to do addition operation, inside sub class you have to do subtraction operation, inside mul class you have to do multiplication operation. And all these methods, inside each and every class you have to create a methods and do the particular operations inside the class. Then you have to create a main function. Inside the main function you have to call the classes by creating object for the class. With use of that object you have to call the methods inside the class. Okay, so totally four classes you have to create, mean by add, sub and mul are the classes. For main function you have to create one more class. Inside the main function you have to create object for those three classes and you have to call those methods inside the class. Okay, next exercise, write a program using method overloading and create five same methods with different parameters. You have to create a five methods using method overloading, and for all five methods you have to pass different parameters. Okay, and you have to call the methods by passing those values. Okay, from the main function. Third program, write a program using this keyword and get int, float and char value and display those values as output. So this keyword program you have to use. You have to create a constructor for the class. Inside that, you have to, after while creating the class, you have to declare an integer variable, floating point variable, and character variable. Then inside the constructor, you have to give this dot integer variable, this dot floating point variable, this dot character variable. Inside the constructor, you are having three parameters that are said to be integer parameter, floating point parameter, and character parameter. So these parameters are passed from the main function. You have to create a object for the class. Inside the class calling, inside the object creation, you have to pass integer parameter, floating point parameter, and character parameter, and you have to call the method. Okay. Inside the method, you have to display all these variables. Okay, you can refer the previous this pointer program for this third exercise. Okay, so these are the basics of understanding class and objects in Java. These things you already know. We did in lab programs. We created classes. We called methods in the lab programs. I hope you may understand these things. These are the basic programs to understand how to create object for the class, how to pass parameters to the class and methods, and how to call a method overloading thing the same way, how to use a this keyword. Okay, these are the four concepts you have to understand in this lecture video. So I hope you understand these things. If you have any doubt, please mail me. All have to listen the video and send the exercise as early as possible. Thank you. Thank you very much.